Many religions have kind of evolved with the time, such as Judaism with female rabbis. However, Hinduism has kind of kept traditional. Why do you think that is? And with most Abrahamic religions, why do you think that is?
You see, it's not just Judaism that has decided to kind of evolve. I mean, the Christian tradition, the Church of England recently agreed that you can have women bishops now. This is again a transition. But when you really look at the transition, it is quite minimal, it's quite limited, a slight, you know, kind of give in the way they kind of practice their religion. When you really analyze, most of the Abrahamic tradition are stuck in a rut. The reason is this. Their prophet lived perhaps 2,000 years ago, and whatever he said is the word of God, and you can't interpret it, you can't, I know, debate about it, or etc. It's fixed. It's all, rules are fixed. So because they've got this fixation on the scriptures and the prophets of the past, they have less room for evolution. They'll kind of just will cut corners here and kind of chisel this bit here, but that's it, minimal. The fact that you can have female rabbi or female bishops in the Church of England is a minor thing, really. There's nothing special. The real religion that is flowing with evolution is Hinduism. The reason is this. We have ancient prophets and we produce modern giants who come with the same message suited to our own times. I'll give you an example. Vivekananda, the person that I am kind of subscribed to, is a very recent prophet of Hinduism who came to the West about 150 years ago and really made a mark on the world stage, saying this tradition is one of the greatest and grandest traditions the world has ever seen. So here you see a modern face of Hinduism, and you see the difference between Vivekananda and the ancient rishis. They were speaking in ancient Sanskrit, and they had to focus on the Vedas, and they're fixated. Is he fixated on it? No. He comes with a new vision. For example, I'll make a very clear comment. With Vivekananda comes this idea. With the ancient prophet, they said, oh, come and sit at my feet and sort you out. With Vivekananda comes a different idea. He said, don't come and sit at my feet, otherwise your journey will stop at my feet. No good. Stand on your own feet and sort yourself out. See the transition. Again, the idea of ancient idea of Hinduism was focusing on gods in heaven and gods and goddesses. He said, give it up. For how many lifetimes will you keep breaking your backbone, bowing down to this god and that god? Stand on your own feet and sort yourself out. Now, isn't it a very different message from the ancient prophet? The reason is this. Look, again, I'm making a very cutting comment. The Hindus had all these 330 million gods, and they were praying to it and so on, and then we had the Muslim invasion, the Christian invasion, our women were raped, slave put in, you know, sent off as slaves, our men were slaughtered, genocide. And then we said we had all these millions of gods, where were they? See? So we had lost up the plot. The plot should have been focusing on humanity, seeing the divinity in human beings, empowering human beings rather than focusing, waiting for some god to jump in. So this transition comes with a modern prophet. Now you see, this is a major transition, not gods in heaven, god in humanity. And this, the Abrahamic tradition can't even think about it. So this is the difference. The Abrahamic tradition kind of very stuck in their kind of system. The theology is very stuck. And there's such horrendous things in the Abrahamic tradition. I'll just give you one example which makes me shudder. You see, the whole, say, Christian theology is based on the idea that the fact that Christ was crucified on Easter is something good. So how can he be good? You murdered a holy man, a God man. How do you murdered him? No. It's with the blood of Christ our sins are absolved. Now, how can he be commonsensical? Just by killing a, you know, godly man, how can human beings' sins are washed away? And this is the central theology. Without it, Christianity collapses. So you see the difference. So they are stuck in a rut with ancient theology, they can't move on. So if they are struggling with evolution, they are struggling. With the Big Bang, they are struggling because you don't have six-day creation and you don't have this idea that Adam and Eve were special cases. We have continuational animal kingdom. So they struggle and they are still struggling. But we are very open saying that if, for example, we get our facts right, we'll get them right. If we got it wrong in the past, we'll get them right now. This is the openness of our system.